Okay.
The Zoombinis need to assemble.
Oh, I gotta start a totally new profile. That's lame. Okay. I should be recording. Keyword should. So let us do this.
Not too long ago, Zoombini Isle was a paradise, home to the happy Zoombinis, who shared their land with the moths that pollinated the snozzleberry bushes that produced fruit for the gentle zerbals. But then the bloats arrived. They pushed aside the Zoombinis and overran their ancestral home. Reluctantly, the Zoombinis fled, but the bloats stayed on, leaving a path of ruin and destruction wherever they went. The once abundant supply of food had dwindled down to nothing, leaving the moths desperate. And so, one day, they left. Eventually, the bloats, having depleted Zoombini Isle of its natural resources, abandoned it in search of new lands to plunder. And it was that day that a daring seagull decided that something must be done.
Seagulls are daring, all right.
He raced to Zoombiniville, the Zoombini's new home, to share the dreadful news. The brave Zoombinis assembled a scouting party, said goodbye to their loved ones, and set off. The Zoombinis arrived at Zoombini Isle and gasped at the devastation. The absence of moths had broken the chain of life necessary to sustain the plants and zerbals on the isle. The Zoombinis sent a messenger home to explain their plan. In order to reverse the catastrophic damage brought on by the bloats and revive the chain of life, the Zoombinis would have to return to Zoombini Isle, each one carrying a caterpillar.
Aww,
the Zoombinis need to assemble a 12-member team to proceed.
Okay. Oh, let's all come out. Let's all come out synchronized, ready to go. Oh, what is that? What is that? Come
There's
on.
There's that Zoombini team spirit.
This is narrator.
Tone on the stones to choose a certain kind of hair. Across the treacherous sea.
Don't care. That's why. Oh, what the hell is this?
Mud balls and heavy boulders can be carried along the gear machine and dropped on the catapult paddle. However, only a boulder is heavy enough to activate the trigger and send a Zoombini to the top of the cliff. Each of the gears in the machine rotates at a certain rate, depending on the number of teeth it has. Also, the catapult paddle changes position at a certain rate, depending on the kind of cam it has inside of its gear. Examine the gears carefully to determine when a boulder should be picked up so that it can be transferred to a basket on the big wheel and then dropped on the paddle. When you're ready, arrange boulders and mud balls in the chute in the correct order. Hint: the gear machine can be turned on and off. Before you place anything in the chute, stop the machine, then restart it when ready.
Right. Okay. So how do I do this puzzle? So let's just turn this machine off for a second. It's only too slow. Okay. I don't know why the middle. Okay, so see how this works. Oh, this is just a timing puzzle. What the hell? Obviously, the balls come around to here. They get placed onto these things, and these things spin all the way around until they get to this point. So now, at this point, it drops. Because right now, you can't get a rock to here, but at that moment, see, I don't know how the physics in this work. When does the actual ball come off? It's actually my problem. So, this is the first level too, so I mean there's 12 stone boulder things, and there's, I guess, some mini amount of mud balls. So keep track of one, so that comes around. Right, so the main thing is this one right here. Okay, I see the puzzle now, I see it. So I just need to get it such that the boulders go into the big gear. That's all I care about. And that'll depend on the speed of the small gears. I see. I got it. That's one. one has to be one. Okay.
Zoombinis that miss the catapult ride will get their chance soon.
R.I.P. in peace.
The fearless Zoombinis catapulted onto the cliffs and arrived at a wall with ancient hieroglyphs.
Oh my god, what is that with my...
protected the towering tum-tum tree. Its leaves are the nutrition that the caterpillars need.
Jesus Christ.
In order to feed the caterpillars tum-tum tree leaves, the Zoombinis must place the tiles into the correct spaces on the wall. The hieroglyphs on the wall correspond to the symbols on the tiles. Each hieroglyph has a matching symbol. Look carefully for patterns in the hieroglyphs and try to find similar patterns on the tiles. For example, if there are two cows and two birds next to each other within a set of four hieroglyphs, the correct match will be a tile that has two pairs of symbols. Each time a tile is placed, the indicator lights show the number of correct matches. Use the information gained from each try to help plan your next placement. Choose your placements wisely. The wall can only withstand so many incorrect attempts.
Yeah, take that. This puzzle seems relatively simple enough. It is the first difficulty, so I should, in theory, have no trouble with it. I'm trying to find... Oh, where the hell is it? It's over here. Okay, so I want an X. Then I want an unknown feature, then I want an unknown feature, then I want a hand, which is a star. So X, something, 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 star. So here I want a circle, and then I want a pentagon, unknown shape, triangle. Circle, pentagon, unknown shape, triangle. So here I want two pentagons that are after each other, which is only one I see here. So that would go here. Relatively simple enough. And so there's only one other feature that begins with a pentagon, so that's that. There's one other feature that begins with a hand. So X corresponds to fish, so that goes up here. A circle is a thingy. Square is a bird mid-flap or something. Two alternating pentagons. Well, I don't need the last one.
Well done, Zoombinis!
What about me? That was me! How was that all the Zoombinis? That was me!
The satisfied caterpillars now form their cocoons, and the Zoombinis hoped they would become moths fairly soon. They had repaired the first link of the chain that brought life, but more work would be needed, both at day and at night.
Oh, what the hell is this?
The Zoombinis arrive at the planetarium to help speed up the metamorphoses of caterpillars into moths. The caterpillars are now in their cocoons. The cocoons are safely stored in the crystals beneath the large clock that divides the two exhibits. The exhibit on the left displays the Earth as it rotates on its axis, while the exhibit on the right shows how the sun moves across the sky when it is viewed from Earth. Each exhibit can show a different time of day or night. For example, if the sun is positioned at the top of the arc, it represents 12 noon. Below the exhibits are several coins, and the number on each coin tells you how many hours it will move the time forward. Place coins into the slots to change the exhibits, so that each one will be positioned to match the time shown on the large clock. If you are successful, a hatch above the exhibit will open to reveal the matching time, and a beam of light will shine upon the crystals to complete the caterpillar's metamorphoses. If you pass the time shown on the large clock, you will still transform some of the moths, but to change them all, each exhibit must stop at the exact time shown on the large clock.
Okay. This should just give me this picture in the first place. Okay, so then... Right, because then the sun's on the right side, so then therefore everything goes in a counterclockwise fashion, basically. Because the Earth rotates... No, it goes clockwise. What am I talking about? The Earth rotates clockwise. I'm slow. So yeah. Okay, I see. I just have to memorize this picture, basically. I know noon's going to be... Okay, so what do I have to do? I have to get what appears to be 3 o'clock. And... So, I'm at this time, which appears to be some number.
The Zoombini?
I need a picture. I don't know, roughly 3 o'clock or so, I guess. That looks like a 3 o'clock. I don't think I have to. Okay, that could be. Okay. Okay, so then the right picture.
The Zoombinis are
here. So then. What matters is that. The tree position indicates. Because it matches up with the thing on the left. Yeah, I see. So 10 a.m. That'll be pointing at noon. So right now it's pointing at some time. Got no idea what this. It says 3 a.m. up here. So I need to go. What? Like. 10, and this would be.
The Zoombinis are rubbing.
So then further on here would be that. I don't know. I feel like I should just see what happens. My brain isn't going to be thinking well enough to grasp this concept. So I'm going to put a 10 here. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Well, I suck. Can I put more coins in? I can. So, what, two? Okay. So this tree thing is at what time?
The Zoombinis arrive.
I'd say it's already there. If not, it's like 20 hours too long.
Did not phase the Zoombinis.
Is that the puzzle? Am I done? What's going on? What do I do? I'm assuming I did it.
But what's this? Not enough moths to continue. More moths will be needed to pollinate the snozzleberry's seedlings.
Oh, I need a group of 12. Damn it.